just recently released for 1.16. I've gone through and updated all the textures to Star Wars textures, Star Wars-ish textures. Just wanted to kind of do like a show off of them. These are, give me just a second. Okay, this is the Crimson Door. This is the Warped Door. Let's go over here. This is the Soul Soil. This was actually the Soul Sand, but because Optifine's not ready yet for 1.16, nowhere near it, the connected textures aren't working for this. This is Block of Netherite. This is the Ancient Debris. This is the Crying Obsidian. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep this, and all these textures are subject to change. This is the warped block, the leaf block or whatever you want to call it. This is the warped nilium, the crimson nilium, the soul fire lantern. Ah, well, look at that, something I didn't change yet. Okay, well, you know what that is, the soul fire torch. This is the warp sign. Crimson sign. This is the nether wart block. The magma block, which y'all remember that. The stripped crimson stem. That's the top. That's the side. This is the side. Top. This is the crimson stem. This is the side. This is the stripped warped stem. This is the Crimson Slab Double. This is the double block of the Crimson Slab. Which actually, I'll show you. Let's see. That's this. That's the, you know, the single versions. Actually, that's the bottom of it. There you go. One higher. There you go. That's the bottom. That's the top. That's the side, and if you stack it normal, it's that, and then the crimson plank, it's the crimson planks, and no, this is the shroom light. Stairs. I don't know if I'm going to keep this. It does work pretty well though, doing the circles for the target block. This is the warped stairs. Of course, you know, fence gate, which I didn't show here. Fence gate and the fence post. Warped and crimson. This is the warped slab. And then that's the bottom. Oh yeah, I didn't change those, did I? Okay. And then let's see. And then that's the double slab block, which I'll show some examples of what I built with these later. This is the warped Hafia and the crimson Hafia. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but you can use them as you can use them as pipes or pillars. As a floor grate, or if you wanted to, you could just use it as a vent. Yeah, maybe. Alright, let's see. It's got a black version and a white version. This is the new nether gold ore. Which I'll show you them all together. This is the warp trap door, which I found a lot of uses for this. I really like this texture. It's pretty awesome. It really looks like the light's reflecting off of it perfectly. It just looks good. I did a good job with that. And then this is the crimson trap door, which is, if you remember, there's like the blue-gray variant from the old game. The rest of the pack. This is the creeping vines. Actually, you can kind of see it better here. And then this, which I'm very proud of, is the twisting vines. Right there. I gotta adjust the texture right there where it meets. It's the next one. I could just texture those to points. But anyways, let's do like a short look around. Oh, with this, if y'all remember, this is the netherrack. It's in the pot, but that's the one right. I can't think of what they're called. And then there's the two mushrooms. Give me just a second. Walk out here. I got a bunch of them planted. That's what they look like planted. Thank you. Simpson stem. Heck, why do they make all these tongue twisters? That's the stripped warp stem. And that's the side of it again. So you can see, just with these new blocks, you can kind of build some pretty cool looking rooms. That's just with these blocks. These are all just the new blocks, well, except for that. The rest of it's new stuff. So that's the forest. What the forest looks like when you're walking through my crimson forest. She looks pretty good. That's the old mushrooms. The new ones. Alright, let's go back. I kind of built like this island. Let's see, I was up here, wasn't I? Because the 3D models aren't working. It's not showing the gun in his hand. It just shows the missing textures model. This makes such awesome flooring. Just that great texture. Man, it's freaking awesome. Come down here. I was just throwing textures or throwing these blocks together. I was curious to see. Just trying to do random stuff with them. See what I mean? See how cool that looks? This looks freaking awesome. You can do that. And then I did one where just even that right there looks cool. Let me see, where am I at? Oh yeah. Was it up here? Yeah. See that's the blue one. The bluish one. Then that's the new gray one. Which this matches up with stuff I did in the other pack. Like I was redoing one of the doors or something, I can't remember. Anyways. Let me see here. Yeah, I was checking out. That's when I was first starting out on the textures. Come back down here. I was just going through, you know, like I said, going through build ideas just to see what you can make stuff look like. All these might not stay the same. I mean, they all do technically work, though. Depending on what you're wanting to do. I guess technically everything can't. It's hard to do 100% Star Wars. Sort of. Which I know there ain't a lot of checkerboards in Star Wars, but I just did it anyways. I wanted to see what it looked like. Had some pillars coming down. Kind of did like this little landing pad out here for, you know, smaller ships. They could come in and fly in and land down. Anyways, let me see. I think that's... I can't wait till they get the connected textures. Messed up thing is that actually doesn't look bad like that. Just being the, you know, the one square texture that it is, even though the connected textures that I have, which you'll notice, like if you're playing 115 or 14 or 13, what it looks like, it looks better than this, but this is still pretty good looking. Still looks pretty damn good. Oh yeah, I didn't really show you these are the warp block, and of course the stem. I still think that looks really cool. I should be able to fly through a forest real quick. There's one. It's not a very big one, but actually, that's why. It's kind of trippy how this one formed. And then this is the old blocks. But you know that's a connected textures block. That's, you know, a 4x4. That's the nether quartz ore. Then the nether bricks is another one. Let me see here. Actually, I think I did. I built somewhere. Yeah, where you can see the old ones. Which are... Oh, yeah. What is this? I think I even showed y'all this one. The basalt. Yeah, the basalt block. It's the basalt block. Which, I got a feeling that one's going to change. I'm probably going to change that to a 4x4 texture at some point. Which, this 4x4 is what that normally grows to, you know, 4 blocks by 4 blocks, 16 blocks total. But no optifine, so it is what it is right now. Nothing else I can do about it. But yeah, that pretty much sums it up. That's the 20A. What is it? 20W11A. Yeah. Update. So I have to say, this is probably most proud of this one. I have to say. I just think that looks. That's shit hot right there. I just like that. That's freaking cool. I think you'd be hard pressed finding a better looking one out there right now. Some of them might make a better one later on, but as of today, which actually I made this last night. I should have made the video last night and posted it. But yeah, day one, that's what I made. Which I don't care, I like it. Alright, folks. I guess we'll close it up here. Tell me what you think. Tell me if you like it or not. Tell me if you're looking forward to it. I won't release none of this until Optifine does their 116, because, I mean, there's no point, because the whole entire rest of the pack looks foobarred without the connected textures mod. All right, folks. Have a wonderful evening, wonderful day, wonderful morning, whenever it is you're watching this. Peace.